is of Barcelona, Correos, done in the year 1912. Then we arrived at a cafe which was open about 2 years ago. And in front are the largest department stores of the city, El Corte Inglés. They have four in Barcelona, this great building, but these are the biggest ones. They are the biggest of Spain, too. It's a stores company that they have stores in all the cities of Spain. On the right is a shopping street called Angel's Gate.
When finished inside in the 16th century, they ran out of money to build a facade. So what they did was to build just a wall and a gate to go inside. So during many years, there was no facade. And King Philip II, who came to Barcelona for a very famous meeting called the first chapter of the Golden Fleece Order. You know, the Golden Fleece Order, or Toison d'Or in French, at that time was the most important order, 1% of the taxes we can give it either to the church or to its, what it's called the social hell. So the church is very rich in buildings, but not in money, let's say. So this area was all restored also at this royal wedding. They put these new lights because here's where they were sitting. All the royal key of the vault. The key of the vault, we see a few of them with the figures, the sculptors, that they represent different saints of the church by the Romans. So, as I said before, the sarcophagus was made in Pisa, in Italy. And then when they come, for instance, last week there were a group of pilgrims from Philippines, then they had here the mass in this bridge, not in the door. And in the one of the counters was a piece of leather, I suppose, of one of the shoes or something like this. But the dawn of the town was not the expense is a story, it's a little bit romantic, it's quite why the rose is a symbol of love. As you know, the story of St. John is that he killed the dragon to liberate the three panels. If you look almost at the top of the towers, you can see this work on tiles of ceramics, broken pieces of glazed ceramics, all put together. This was designed by Gaudí, but was done in Murano, in Venice, Italy. On the towers, you will see a lot of Latin words, like Sanctus, 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 Holy, Holy, Holy. Then you can see the Tree of Life, this sort of Christmas tree with birds made of ceramics. If you look at the columns, they look like a stalactites and a stalagmites. Always this conception of the nature, the inspiration in the nature. All is a little bit twisted. Then under the tree is a cave where it represents the coronation of Mary, when Jesus puts the crown on his mother's head. It's all the facade, like all the buildings of God. You can see the birth of Jesus. Jesus, Mary, Joseph, the angels on the top. On both sides you have the angels blowing the trumpets, announcing to the world the birth of Jesus. And you can see the bridge behind the tree. This bridge connects the four towers. People who go inside, they can go upstairs. There are very small steps, 270, to go up to the bridge and to pass from one side to the other. It's all concrete. And on the peak of the towers, the little balls that represent different types of fruits, the nature again. Now, since 2 years, we have these cranes working over there, building the roof of the naves. And according to the Bishop of Barcelona, go down to the block with white balconies down there. You see the... Jesus on the cross, the death of Jesus. People criticize very much the artist because Jesus is completely naked. And a little further down, you see the Veronica, the woman with no face, with a cloth where he's pinned the face of Jesus. Jesus, yes, has the head like this. Yeah. And then this artist, before he started to work here, he wanted to be like where it's going to be the main altar. And under the earth is where is the crypt where Gaudi was buried. And there is also a chapel, which one is open on Sunday for the masses. And in Barcelona, it's traditional to get married there. Everybody can do the ceremony, but when you get married there, they expect you a donation to help them to continue the work of the church.
Hyundai Coupe. Good looking, that poor little lad.
Yeah.
The other one's really tall. Yeah. You know. Thank you.
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. Can I have your attention, please? This is a final call for those passengers travelling on the BAR3.
Kids were the only ones left.
There were some after us, I think. Two groups still.
Yeah. I mean, that one does, but you know, we only did a lot of people, I guess. I don't know what I'm doing. I don't know what I'm doing. I don't know what I'm doing. I don't know what I'm doing.